everyone, this is LJ from Pureco, and we're doing something a bit fun today. So I'm just showing you how I create a boatwood look using our coloured stains. And we have a little helper today. Oh, this is my little baby. Well, she's not a baby, she's 12 years old. This is Penny. Hey, she's come to work with us today, didn't you, baby? But she's a pat thief. Keep stealing pats, don't you? Me? Okay, you stay there. Come on, you stay there. Good girl. Okay. Nice distraction. Hey, good girl. Okay, so basically all I've done to prep this bit of wood, it's the back of a cabinet door. So I've stripped it, and because I didn't want the stains to kind of sink right in the wood, I wanted to be able to sand them back really easily and get a weathered look, I did a coat of matte sealer first, and then I used our texture medium and mixed that with driftwood stain and just put some little areas in there with a bit of texture, so I had that sort of salty look. So I'll show you how I did like these two panels, and it's so super easy. So I did the texture with the stain yesterday because it needs overnight to dry, and you can mix our texture finish with any of our products. So we actually have five actual coloured stains in our range. So we have Petal, which is a pink, Cranberry, our red, Mermaid, a nice green, and then we have Periwinkle, which is a purple, and Denim, which is a blue. So there's a few colours there, and you can also mix them, and you can mix the White Whisper stain if you want like a really pale baby blue. You can mix them together and make up your own colour combos. So basically that the boat wood is kind of it's when pieces of old boats, when they take them apart and that sort of thing, and they've been previously painted, and you actually layer them like this with all the different colors that the boats have been. So it's really nice rustic weathered sort of look. But also when you're doing things with a lot of color, it can really lend itself to that real bohemian look as well, which I really like. So I'll show you what I did. I might just do a bit of purple. Yeah, and it's really easy. You can put as little or as much stain as you want. I basically brushed it on, but you can put it on with a cloth, or you can use a sponge as well. Okay. Penny's just sitting here really getting pats from Anna. Like, she's not moving.
I don't have a choice.
She goes, stuff you, mummy. I'm getting pats from Anna.
Oh, she's loving it too.
Yeah, she's a little pat fiend. Okay. And she'll sit there and bash you with her nose when she wants pats. So this is our periwinkle. So it's a really nice sort of mid-range purple. And basically, I'm just painting it on over the top of the driftwood. And I did mask off some areas so that I had like different lengths of wood, but realistically you don't really have to mask it off because it's kind of got to look rough anyway. And the good thing with using the stains instead of, because you could do it with paint as well and just distress it back, you've still got a bit of the wood grain showing through. So I think that looks really cool. And it's just nice to do something a bit different. If you've got a bohemian piece, you could do this on the top as your finish, on the top of your wood, your piece of furniture. Can't get my words out today. So that's just applied that, and then I just leave that to dry, and I'll paint out the others, and then we can see what it looks like towards the end. And traditionally they don't follow any sort of pattern. It just is whatever, you know, wood they can find from the boots. So easy to use, these stains. I love them. Always been a little bit wary of staining myself. I always freak out when I'm putting it on that I'm going to you know, put too much on, not enough. And but these are just so easy to use. And if you are a bit scared using the stains, my tip is to have a just a damp cloth, and I'll show you. You can pretty much remove it really quite easily. So see that? You can just basically wipe it off before it's sunk into the wood. And the fact that I put the matte sealer on there first helps as well. It doesn't sink in as much. So you can get a really subtle effect as well if you're worried that the stain's going to be too dark. You're much better off doing lighter, many light coats than just going nuts and putting a really heavy coat on, because your light coats, you can build up the colour and you get it to the desired shade that you want just by building it up slowly. And always apply with the grain, don't go across the grain. So what's that, purple and a bit of pink? Where are you going, puppies? Hey, where are you going? Do you want to get down? Hey, you want to get down? Come on. Oh, there you go. You can't go out the front though.
Sit on that. Sit on that.
Alrighty, I think I might just do a bit of blue up there. Has anyone used my white tricks from last week? Had a few people message me about it. This is more my thing, do it using colour. Open it. Oh, and the trucks are here again. Yay! So with the texture medium, you can just paint over it, or you can mix any of our paint stains like in the texture, and it takes on the color of the actual paint you're using. So this blue is a nice strong blue, like the cranberry. They're a nice strong color. So this is one where you could wipe back and have like a paler version of it. And walk about, darling girl. You can also, which is something I probably could have showed you that today too, is using the coloured stains. You can use a mister and blend with them as well on your raw wood. There is nothing to say that you can't do that. It's they'll blend really well, just like, so you can see how you can really wipe it back, and then you've just got a hint of the blue in the wood there. So don't be shy with the colours. Like, you can go nuts like you do with paint.
Someone asked, is that greyish stuff the texture medium?
Yes, I mixed the texture medium with the driftwood stain and glaze, because I wanted a little bit of that sort of driftwood colour coming through, because this wood was a bit darker. Usually, you know, like salt, sea sand and salt affected wood is a lot, driftwood, I guess, it's called, is a lot lighter and gives that bleachy look. So that's why I've added just a little bit of that with the texture. So when I sand it back, you'll be able to see how that works. Okay, I might do another bit of the red, I think, down there.
Oh my god, I stopped patting her for 1 second.
She like, looks at me like,
don't
hey.
Stop patting, don't stop patting.
Pats forever.
She follows us everywhere, this little puppy. Sleeps in our bed. She's spoilt rotten. I don't know if you can see. So you can see how dark the red is. It's got quite a lot of pigment in it. Let's get it in that green. And I've just got the tiniest bit on my brush there. I'll take this tape off. I taped it off thinking, oh yeah, I'll have a nice edge, but really don't need a nice edge because it's supposed to look battered. So, you know, sometimes I have these brilliant ideas. Okay. Do you want to grab me a whisper? And I'll do I'll mix a colour. And just a little... Oh, here, no, it's alright, I've got some. That's alright, just grab a one off the shelf. So I'll show you how you can mix a custom colour as well. Thanks, sweetie. So this is our white called Whisper. And I think I might make a a lighter blue. I'm such a champ at getting these things. Oh dear, so funny. Oh my goodness, do it for me. I'm all fingers and thumbs today. Right, so I'm going to put a bit of blue.
Jesus.
I know.
Sometimes
that's what
really
I thought too.
Sometimes. Oh, got it.
Beautiful. Thanks, my lovely. So you just mix the stains together like you would paint. And there you've got a mid blue.
Hi Sharon.
Hey Shaz, how you doing? Okay. That here. Oh, this is really nice blue actually,
yeah.
Like a nautical sort of Hamptons blue. I can hear Penny sniffing around.
Yeah.
Her little nose. So there you can, it's just as easy. You can mix your own custom colours. And also with this look, you can do a can do it with paint as well. Do a bit of ochre. Might spray. No, that's okay. So I've just got a bit of our our ochre paint in the chalk. I need a bit of water.
Someone said a light pink would be lovely.
Yeah, I can do I can mix and do a pink here for you today. Got a dry brush. Okay. Yeah, I can easily mix a pink. We've got the petal, which is mid pink, so I can add a bit of whisper to that. Can you grab me another container? Just grab one from out there. So we can mix a bit of pink.
Hey, Penny.
Because a really pale pink would look beautiful on a tabletop, a little girl's room. Do a nice, really subtle. Yeah, so you've got a really nice pale pink there. So you can really, you know, develop your own colour. Oh, I need another paintbrush now. Here you go. Just clean that one off. So I'll use this pink on the last panel. Oh, that's really pretty. Okay, so there you can see we've got all of our panels covered. So I'll dry these off and I'll just show you what I did with the other two layers. And there's nothing to say that you even have to do straight lines. You could do, you know, just little swipes of colour, blend it, or sort of half blend it and half not. I just kind of like the look of the boat wood panels. Now you're picking up all my little messes over there. A wash with your colours, just a tiny bit of paint and water. If you didn't have any coloured stains, there's nothing to stop you using the paint. You just have to seal it afterwards, whereas these stains don't need sealing. Got a penny here there. going to get that drying on the wood really quickly, but not on the texture. You could also just do the texture all over it and then paint it like this and sand it back as well. I just did it in some just random areas, but it would look really nice if you did the texture underneath the whole thing. Enough for me to do a little bit. So all I did once those were dry is basically, let's see, it's a little bit sticky still, but I can still show you what I did. So because I've got this, you know, crisp line here, I want to blur that out a little bit. And then I just sand over the stain to pull through some of that driftwood texture. And there's no rule with how much you sand. You can go crazy, or you can just have a little bit of subtle distressing. And again, I want to blur that line a little. And you want to soften all the edges. This, you can also hit this with a sander, yeah. Not just your hands, but it's a bit loud to do that on the video. And it's completely up to you, like how much sanding you do and how far you take back to the driftwood texture. But you can see how you've just got, like, there's a little bit back there down to raw wood. You can probably take a little bit. The trick is to try not to make it look even. You want it to look very random and, you know, no uniformity to it. That's sort of the trick with a lot of these sort of looks.
Leanne Waters says hi. Hi, Leanne.
Hi, Leanne. That pink is gorgeous. It looks so nice, like in real life. Like, it is really pretty. And it's really nice with the driftwood as well.
Yeah. This old piece on Instagram suggested
you do
that.
Nice one.
Good suggestion.
Good suggestion.
And Michelle, she said, I'm so going to do this.
Is that our Michelle?
Yep.
Yep. I knew you'd be all over this, lovely. Michelle does the beautiful tabletops with like a million colours.
She's like the queen of colour on
it. Yep. So there you can see, that's pulled it back a little bit. And you can see it is a bit hard to see there, but where the driftwood has come through on those pieces. But it's just something a little different. Like, this would be gorgeous on an outdoor bar tabletop kind of thing. That's what comes to my mind when I think about it. And just kind of, there's no rules. You just go nuts.
Really.
And then also you could leave some of the panels as raw wood as well. You can, put a resist on it as well. So you can wax areas underneath so that when you're trying to stain or paint over that area, the paint won't stick. So as you sand back or wipe back, you'll have like these areas wherever you've put the wax to use as a resist as well. So that's another idea. And you can use any colour with the texture. Like I could have used black or a dark grey, which would have looked really good as well, or even just a white. So it's just a really fun, something different. Be cool for a kid's room.
It would even look nice just doing all different shades of brown stains.
Yeah, yeah, grays. definitely.
Not into the bold colours.
Yeah. So once I finish, I'll take a photo so you can actually see it better. but yeah, it's just a different way to use the coloured stains and, you know, introduce those to everyone. Not everyone knows we even do coloured stains. I could just do this all day.
Yeah.
Like, just play.
Yeah.
Can you see that? You're like watching me going, what are you doing? It's time to stop.
Come back to this a couple times today.
Okay, so I'll just dust this off a bit and I will. My thoughts were to finish this off with some white wax. So that's what I'm gonna do. You don't have to seal the our stains and you can also use them as a glaze as well. So you just basically pop that all in there, and this will just lighten it up as well, help with that driftwood look. Just soften the colours back a little bit as well. So normally when I wax a piece, I will wax it and then leave it, especially if I've used a coloured wax, I'll leave it overnight and then buff it the next day. I usually kind of go with the grain, but you don't have to. Just because I'm doing a coloured stain and the item is sort of all about grain, the wood grain, so I'm sort of going with that. With the white wax over the top, and I'll just grab my towel. Hi Kay, how are you going?
Boy, I didn't even know she's from Tassie. Fun.
Yeah, I thought it said Texas first. I'm going, oh my god. And so after you have applied your wax, I usually leave it overnight, but I'll just buff this back a little to show you. So it just softens that look a little bit, and you can keep adding, taking away. You can add a bit of dark wax, you can add a bit of black wax and go a bit nuts. So yeah, that's just something fun and different to do. And also when you wax it, it'll bring up, so you can see how it's brought up more of that wood look. Here instead of the just the paint, and it'll deepen the shade of the paint and the stain as well. But because you're doing it with a white, see, I'm sort of taking the white off at the moment because I haven't left it to sort of sit and sink in. But yeah, it'll kind of like I don't know, it just gives, I can't even explain it. When I love waxing furniture, and it gives it, I don't know, it's a type of depth that your sealers just can't do. I can't even explain it really, because I don't, my brain's not thinking of the right words, but it's, yeah, I don't know. And it's so smooth. I like the feel of the wax.
Yeah, it's
really...
if you haven't used wax before to seal something, you really should give it a go.
It's really lovely. It's a really kind of... Yeah. And you can buff it up to a shine. A lot of people are worried that wax is... oh my goodness. Where are my words today?
Matt.
I should remember that. My brother's name's Matt. Mm-hmm. As a matte finish, but you can actually really get a beautiful sheen on a wax piece, and it lasts just as well as a sealer. I've got pieces in my house that I painted before I was married, and I've been married 6 years, so and we're hard on the gear at home. Like, we've got dogs inside, cats, and yeah, we just seem to just destroy everything. But anyway, nothing stays so very nice in our house for a long time. But we use everything, you know. So it's really held up really well. So will it stand up to heavy use on a coffee table? Yeah, it will. Once it's cured and the waxes are all set in, it will. And it's waterproof because it will repel water as well. Be careful for sort of the first month or so and use coasters, but yeah, we'll most definitely stand up on a coffee table top. So there you go.
We do have someone from Texas, JoJo Furniture Makeover. Shout out to her on Instagram.
Oh, wow.
All the way in Texas.
Hey JoJo, that's awesome.
Right? Oh my god.
That's amazing. Thank you for watching.
Just making nervous.
Yeah, this is our colour called Ochre. This yellow here. It's one of my favourites too. When I lived in the UK in the 90s, I lived overseas for a few years. And I don't know if any of you might remember. I think it was here in Australia. But while I was over there, there was this show called Changing Rooms. And I was telling Iana about it last week, and this I did my whole, like in the UK when you rent a property, you're allowed to re-carpet and paint and whatever you want to the house. So I had this color was my kitchen. I had yellow kitchen with like blue accessories. And that whole show, Changing Rooms, was all like 90s ragging, different coloured walls, like accent walls, and yeah, I loved it.
surprise.
But I don't know if anyone else remembers it or whether it was here in Australia, but yeah, it was in the UK. I think I even, you know, the news agents, when you get like folders that you collect every month, I'm pretty sure I got all those too. But so have a bit of fun with some colour. I was complete opposite to the video last week on white. And this is more fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
So thank you so much for watching.
Giveaway.
And giveaway. Good giveaway. I always forget. Lucky you're here, kiddo. So our giveaway from last week was for someone to try a cloud, which is our slightly greyish off-white. And then our cotton, which is our beautiful, like, soft off-white. So our winner, who will receive these, little puppy's going nuts, is Nikki Goldspink Chafee. Hopefully I said that right, Nikki, sorry. So if you would like to share this video or tag someone that you think may enjoy it, you get to... go in the draw for your choice of a coloured stain and your choice of one of our waxes. Okay, so thank you again for watching, and we'll see you next week, and happy painting. Thank you.